think, yeah, it's laziness, I think it's ignorance, it's apathy. It's that whole out of sight, out of mind kind of scenario where they're not exposed to those impacts, so therefore they don't think that they themselves have an impact. I think a lot of people, if they saw what I saw in terms of the effect, I'm pretty sure that would change their minds pretty quick. So quite a long lived, you know, you can imagine almost like a human lifespan.
This one's only probably about 5 years old.
So it's a little juvenile. There is a possibility that there's more of them coming down and staying for longer and actually residing in our coastal habitats in the far north. And some of those have ingested quite a large amount. They're long lived, so then the probability of them encountering plastics in the natural environment is high. They are wide ranging, they live in the ocean in the epipelagic zone, where quite often you'll get these convergent zones of nutrients and zooplankton, but also the accumulation of rubbish. These animals ingest plastics inadvertently that they're mistaken for their own prey items, and as a consequence of that you get quite a large amount being embedded within the stomachs of these animals and start to accumulate and form what's known as a gut impaction. They die pretty slowly and quite horribly. I don't think I'd want to think about what it'd be like to have a ball of plastic in my stomach and slowly kill me. The main thing I find is just single-use packaging and plastics. It's I've pulled out whole clear white plastic bags from turtles.
I don't think you ever get hard into the fact that, you know, an endangered species has died because of our careless actions, you know.
We're quite proud of our connection with the sea and all that sort of thing. We consider ourselves kaitiaki or, you know, guardians and all that sort of thing. It's really, you know, embarrassing to see that result, that, you know, something that we've done as a nation really results in the decline of these species.
Yeah, it makes me angry, makes me sad. That's probably the most frustrating thing, is it doesn't require, you know, no major advance in technology. It just, all it needs is some people to sit around a policy table and say, we don't need single-use plastics, let's get rid of them.
If people consider that convenience outweighs the price that we pay in terms of loss of biodiversity and loss of endangered species, and that's a really sad indictment of us as humans.